Here's your new desk, kid. You're on traffic. The hot sheet is posted here next to the map.
What's his problem?
That's Biggs. He's an institution.
So this is what all the fuss is about. Why couldn't they build a freeway that goes past my place?
They haven't even approved the money yet, kid. The bond issue won't be till December. It'll be years before any of this will happen. Here's your new partner, Stefan Berkowski.
I've heard all about you, Phelps. You go easy on me and let me earn the odd citation, and maybe we'll get along fine.
I'm here to learn, Detective.
He's an intense one, isn't he, Mel?
Who's intense?
The newly minted detective here, Cole Phelps.
Hi, Phelps. I'll be keeping an eye on you. I could spend a little time basking in reflected glory. Make a change from busting hookers and dope fiends.
Who was that, Commander?
Roy Earl, Chief Detective and Advice.
Do they all dress like movie stars?
Well, Roy is a movie star. And the whole of the seedy side of L.A. is his audience.
What is that supposed to mean?
Stick with me, kid. You'll find out.
Now some housekeeping. Warm Central Division welcome for Detective Cole Phelps. Some of you guys may know Phelps. He's the cop who broke the jewelry store murder. Stand up and take a bow, Phelps.
If it's all right with you,
sir.
That's
an order, Phelps.
Ooh.
Shh, quiet, everybody.
Phelps is one of only two serving LAPD officers who received the Silver Star during the war. Really gave it those lousy Japanese, eh, Phelps?
I did my best, Captain.
Why are you war heroes always so modest? I've partnered Phelps with everybody's favorite Pole, Stefan Bukowski.
Hope you like work, kid. Bukowski sure as hell doesn't.
Well, that's why we have partners, right?
Okay, can it, guys. Stick with Bukowski. He's a good cop. He knows traffic inside and out. I'm going to start you out with one case. You do okay, I'll give you a couple more. You screw up, you'll be rousing vagrants and running license plates. Now get down to the P.E. Freight Depot, 6th and Alameda. A patrolman called in a suspicious vehicle. Signs of foul play. See what you can find out.
Come on, Phelps.
You know you've got it made if you can get to that desk.
Are you drunk, mister? Or are you just cracked?
They really pushed you through quick, didn't they? 6 years on patrol before I got to this desk. You were here in 5 minutes.
What do you want me to say? I didn't ask for any favors. You know this place?
Sure. Near the old gas works and signal depot in the warehouse district. I'll direct.
Stone cold dead in the market. Stone cold dead in the market.
So, tell me a little about yourself, Phelps. Are we friends now, Bukowski? We have to work together. Don't be so touchy.
I grew up in San Francisco. My father was in shipping. Went to college at Stanford. Did 2 years ROTC before Marine OCS at Camp Elliott. Shipped out in early 45 as a first lieutenant. Fought in the Okinawa campaign. I was wounded. Shipped back home. Did a year on the beat. Now I'm here.
So you won the Silver Star.
I don't want to talk about it.
Now let me get this straight. You single-handedly killed 40 Japs on this hill in Okinawa.
No. You were up there all night.
Draped in the flag, knife between your teeth, gun at the ready.
Finished?
The Emperor Hirohito himself leading the charge against you.
I did my part, Bukowski. What did you do?
All units of 459 just occurred at 6th and Saris. Any unit to handle, code 2, identify.
Yeah, now I get it. Unfit for service.
Oh, fuck you, Phelps. I earned a bravery citation during the Zuta riot.
That you, Bukowski? Go on through. Parking lot straight ahead.
I need to get back to work, officer.
The detectives are here now. You repeat to them what you told me.
I did the right thing by calling this in. I'm just a working stiff.
Just give them your story and you'll be all right.
This is your first case, Phelps. It's okay to admit it if you're stumped. If you don't know what to do next, just come talk to me and we'll see what we can figure out.
Thanks, Stefan. You're okay.
I'm Officer Hart.
Phelps, traffic. What have you got?
Abandoned car, probably stolen. The solid citizen is Nate Wilkie. He called it in.
What gives with the coroner?
There's blood all over the interior. Someone's copped a full Broderick, but no stiff as yet.
We have an owner for the car?
The car is registered to an Adrian Black, just north of Bunker Hill.
All right, we'll take a look around.
I'll keep Mr. Wilkie talking, but don't make him wait too long. He's the restless type.
Nice day for it.
Doc?
How long you gonna keep
Detective
here,
Phelps. What have we got?
A lot of blood for a blunt force injury. Victim must be in a very bad way.
Any sign of the guy?
Not unless he's in the trunk of the car.
Have you got a wide shot of the car and its surroundings?
Listen, you and I have never met, so I'm just going to go ahead and say this once. If you don't tell me how to do my job, then I won't tell you how to do yours.
Mr. F. Morgan picked up a live pig yesterday?
Not sure this means much.
Victim looks to have lost a lot of blood.
Giving me anything to go on.
Stenzel glasses. Home repaired by the look of it. ''32 years old, married, sounds like an average guy. What was he doing out here? Happier times, I guess. Brand name might give us something to go on. Sir, I'm Detective Phelps.
Name's Nate Wilkie.
You found the vehicle?
Sure. Saw it just sitting there. Strange place to be parking your car. Figured I'd better take a look. And then I saw all the blood. So I called the police.
Mind if I ask what you were doing out here?
Well, I work for the railway. I was on my way out to the switch and reckon I'd take a shortcut.
Did you see anybody else in the yard? Maybe somebody hanging around the car?
Nope. I hadn't seen a soul all day till you boys turned up.
Do you know Adrian Black, Mr. Wilkie?
No, sir. That ain't a name I'm familiar with.
You ever seen the car before?
Funny enough, I did. A couple of nights ago, it was over there in the parking lot. I know most of the cars are parked here regular, so it kind of stood out.
The wallet by the car. Was there anything in it when you arrived?
You accusing me of something, mister?
Do you want the patrolman to hold you down while we turn out your pockets, Mr. Wilkie?
Maybe I checked inside that wallet. Not that I was gonna steal anything. Maybe I took a look. But there weren't no money in there. Not even change.
We found a steel pipe with blood on it near the car. Do you know anything about it, Mr. Wilkie?
No, sir. I went straight for the law when I saw the car was full of blood.
When you saw the blood, was it wet, bright red, or darker like it is now?
Darker, I'd say. Looked dry already.
Thank you for your help, Mr. Wilkie. We'll contact your employer if we need anything more from you.
If you have to, I guess. I can't really spend no more time over this.
Somebody's got to inform the wife, Phelps. You're done here. We'll head over there now. Bunker Hill Avenue. You know where that is?
Behind Bunker Hill. A couple blocks north of Central Station.
So, what do we tell the wife?
We play it by the book. There's no stiff yet, so let's see how it plays out.
Any Century Unit of 415, possible mental case. And 7th and Flower, Unit to handle code 3, identify.
Could be a car theft gone wrong. Make Black drive somewhere lonely, then give him a tap.
But why leave the car?
Well, obviously, someone got a little heavy-handed.
It's the wrong way around.
Well, how so, genius?
Where is Adrian? If you've gone to all the trouble to steal the car, and it goes wrong, you leave the body behind, not the car.
You got something there, Phelps. It doesn't add up.
Did you read about the guy on the crossing yesterday?
No, what happened?
Over on Lincoln Avenue. This guy's driving along and his oil light comes on. He stops the car and gets out. He pops the hood and...
He's on a rail crossing.
Oh, you got it. He's got his head under there checking the oil and the Southern Pacific Freight slams into his car doing 90 miles an hour. The car came to a rest more than a mile down the track.
What a pointless waste of life.
You'll get plenty of blood and guts and mindless stupidity working traffic, Phelps. And who needs a Second Amendment when we'll give a goddamn fool the license to get behind the wheel of an automobile?
If it's a kidnapping, why leave the victim's ID? If it's a murder, why leave the car? The evidence doesn't add up.
Free lesson, Phelps. Evidence will only get you so far. You ask me, the whole thing feels...
Let's go introduce ourselves. You talk to her, Phelps. I'm no good at this shoulder to cry on stuff.
Just a minute.
LAPD, Mrs. Black. May we come in? We have some bad news, and we'd rather discuss this in private.
I'm Margaret Black. We can discuss this in the living room. Please come in.
Your husband drives a blue Lincoln, Mrs. Black?
That's correct.
The car has been found abandoned, and I'm afraid there are signs of foul play.
I knew something was wrong when he didn't come home.
We believe your husband may be injured. We found a pipe on the scene with blood on it.
Oh, no! My poor Adrian!
Does the name InstaHeat mean anything to you, ma'am?
Yes, it does. We've just had a new water heater installed.
Whereabouts, Mrs. Black?
Just outside the kitchen window, at the side of the house.
I'd like you to try and stay calm and remember everything that you can about last night. My partner and I are going to take a look around. When you're ready, we're going to have some more questions for you. Is that okay?
Of course, officer. Anything to help secure my husband's safety.
Well, let's check the place out. Come on. Have a good look around. There's got to be something in here to go on.
Lie down, make yourself comfortable. So, you're a friend of Courtney's?
Yes, doctor.
He seems very concerned about you.
I have these visions, these blinding visions. I can't get them out of my head. My skull, it feels like it's in a vice.
I'm going to give you something to calm your nerves. I want to take you on a journey back. I want you to remember the good things about your past, occasions that made you laugh, times that made you smile.
Kavanaugh's. So who brought this home?
Maybe Adrian was a patron. R and I should have an address.
This must be Adrian's. Stenzel. So the glasses are a match. To my Adrian. This thing gets more and more interesting. used ticket to Seattle and a suitcase gone missing. Someone couldn't wait to get out of this house. Separate bedrooms, separate pictures. What gives here? Operator, give me dispatch.
Putting you through now.
Cole Phelps, badge 1247.
How could I help, Detective?
I need an address on a Kavanaugh's bar.
Certainly, Detective. One moment. Kavanaugh's bar, corner of Aliso and Hewitt, south side of Union Station.
Thank you. No use leaving the thing half finished. So the pipe missing from Mr. Black's heater is the same one that killed him. Huh. Seems like the assailant is a little closer to home.
I doubt it.
I'm all right now, detectives.
We found a receipt in the trunk of your husband's car for a live pig. This receipt was made out to an F. Morgan.
A pig? Adrian runs a tool business. That would be Frank Morgan. God knows what he's up to.
What makes you say that about Morgan, ma'am?
He's the foreman at my husband's plant. A very shady character. I've told Adrian he needs to keep his distance from the staff. They're always out drinking together.
Your husband frequents Kavanaugh's bar?
How did you know that? Adrian practically lives there after work.
So Adrian spends a lot of time there?
Up until recently, he's been away in Seattle a lot on business.
Did your husband tell you where he was going last night?
All he said was he was going to meet Frank for a drink.
So nothing out of the usual then?
Well, he came home early from work. He never comes home early. And he went out early too. He normally never leaves for the bar till about 7.
Was your husband wearing his glasses when he left here yesterday?
Yes, he just bought a new pair.
Go on.
I kept telling him to throw those old ones away. He tried to repair them with tape. They looked terrible.
Tell us about the photo of Adrian in the bedroom.
What is there to tell? It's from his most recent business trip to Seattle.
There's plenty to tell. You just won't tell it. You're lying about the photograph, Mrs. Black.
You're incredibly rude and insensitive. But I guess you know that. I've told you what I know about the picture.
What about Nicole, Mrs. Black? Was your husband going to leave you for her?
I've seen the photo frame. He thinks I'm stupid. But women sense these things. I don't know if he intended to leave me or if it was just a fling. God only knows. I only want to know that he's safe.
I think you should come clean with us, Mrs. Black. Your husband is missing, and after our search, I'm willing to call the circumstances suspicious. Can you account for your movements last night?
You're not accusing me, are you? What an awful thing to say. I was here all night, of course, waiting for Adrian to come home.
Is there anyone who can vouch for that?
Well, no. I was here alone. I cooked Adrian's dinner and waited, but he never came home.
We'll keep you informed, Mrs. Black.
Please do, Detective.
You drive. I need to go over the case notes.
Where are we going?
That's the guy from the paper.
Jesus, I'm glad to be out of there.
Mr. and Mrs. Black don't seem to have the happiest home life.
He's too scared to divorce her, and she's too much of a shrinking violet to throw him out. If this hadn't happened, they could have stayed miserable together forever.
You think she could have killed him?
She sure as hell doesn't seem the type. But stranger things have happened.
Hey, I know you.
No, you don't.
Looking for someone?
I can't decide between the tuna fish and the chicken.
You know Frank Morgan?
Sure. Frank's your regular. He's a loner in the back.
He's dull as dishwater.
Frank Morgan?
Who's asking?
Cole Phelps, LAPD. I understand you're a friend of Adrian Black.
Yeah, I know him.
Are you aware that he's missing?
No, I hadn't heard that. Tough break.
We found Black's car, abandoned in a freight depot, covered in blood. You know anything about that, Morgan?
Hell no. I'm sorry to hear that. I like Adrian. He's a good boss.
Please, don't tell me you actually believe this jerk-off, Phelps.
You're lying, Morgan. You were there.
And you're talking out your ass, Detective. How about you prove I was out at that rail yard? Well, if it's all the same to you, I'll go back to my drink.
You were there, Morgan. We found a receipt in the trunk of the car. It has your name on it. We can call the slaughter yard and nail you on it.
All right, already. That fool Adrian's fallen for some dame in Seattle. He wanted me to make it look like he'd been attacked.
Where exactly is Black holed up?
No idea. I think he took off for Seattle.
I'm tired of your shtick, Morgan. Spill it! Or we take you out in the alley and we knock it out of you.
He's holed up at my place. He's waiting for some money to come through before he blows town.
An address?
It's an apartment house at the corner of Temple and Figueroa. Apartment number 2.
I think that's all. Thanks for your help, Morgan. We appreciate it.
Hey, I'm just glad I could help. I love cops. Cuff him, let him go. It's up to you, Phelps. There's no way I'm writing this idiot up. You got Morgan's address? Let's get over to his apartment.
You know the way. You can drive.
All right. Where to?
Car 11K, come in.
11K, go ahead.
Message from Technical Services. Bug found in the abandoned Lincoln at the PE Freight Depot is not human. Repeat, not human. Compositional analysis reveals swine as the most likely match.
Roger, KGPL. Time to reel this guy in, Phelps. Check the place out. Come on.
Apartment 2.
Help you, gentlemen?
LAPD detectives, Mr. Black. You're under arrest.
Look, I'm really sorry about this. I never tried to hurt anyone. I just needed to get away from LA. I won't put up a struggle. Just let me get my things.
I knew it! Phelps, go after him. I'll try and head him off in the car. Remember, the gun is the last resort.
There's no point running, Adrian. Mr. Black, get back here right now. It's over, Adrian.
Stop right there, Adrian.
Why not just come clean with her, Black? Why the melodrama?
I thought it would be easier.
No, it just got a whole lot harder. Adrian Black, you're under arrest for conspiracy and fraud. We'll see what the DA has to say about wasting police resources on a wild goose chase like this.
You're gonna lose your wife, lose your job, and probably end up in the big house. I hope she was worth it, Adrian.
That turned out to be quite some case, huh?
Adrian, what an idiot. You got an arrest and a clearance in your first case, and in fine style, too. Well done, detective. Efficient investigation technique, good public presence. You keep that up and you learn from Bukowski here, and you could go a long way in this department.